गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हेयर टुडे वी आर हैविंग द ओवरव्यू ऑफ एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड्स। इन दैट वी विल डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द वेरियस हार्मोन्स विच कैन बी सीक्रेटेड फ्रॉम द वेरियस ऑर्गन्स। सो एज द ह्यूमन बॉडी इज हैविंग वेरियस ऑर्गन्स लाइक किडनीज, आफ्टर दैट एड्रेनल ग्लैंड, पैनक्रियाज, गोनेड्स लाइक दिस, फीमेल गोनेड लाइक ओवरीज, male gonad, testes. Now there was one scientist whose name is Claude Bernard. He was the French physiologist and he have brought the concept of internal physiology, that is homeostasis, for the first time in the world. So he have brought that concept. So body maintain the internal environment automatically, and this was new for all over the world. And in that the brain is involved, especially from brain hypothalamus is involved, and due to which body is maintaining the immune system, that is maintaining the various reproductive system, and also the chemical messengers like hormones, for example human endocrine system. Now as the human endocrine system is able to release various types of hormones, various cells are there. For example, the beta cells of Langerhans is there. After that, the gonad cells are there. They are able to release the various hormones. And the endocrine system will control our heart, it will control our metabolism, it will control our growth, our sexual determination, after differentiation, development, reproduction. So all these things can be covered by this endocrine system. Now they are also controlling the nervous system as well as immune system. In nervous system they can be control our walking, our various activities like respiration. And in immune system they can control our pathogenic entry in our body. They will fight against the various pathogens, though it is slow but it is working in our body. And also it is responsible for our growth, our development, our height, our body structure. And also it is responsible for the various vital organs. Our autonomic system also controlled by our endocrine system, like maintenance of blood electrolytes and also body metabolic rates. Various cells are available in our body and their cells metabolism is controlled by our endocrine system, especially thyroid glands. Now here the thyroid gland, so it is at the mediastinum part of our body and it is having shape of butterfly shape, and there are the four tiny structures are there. They are located at the lateral positions of the thyroid gland. From the back side they are called as parathyroid gland. Both thyroid glands are having their main functions. For example, now this thyroid gland is able to secrete the T3 and T4, thyroxine and triiodothyronine. They are responsible for various metabolic functions, whereas this parathyroid hormone, it's secreting the parathormone or parathyroid hormone, which is responsible for controlling the calcium and phosphate level in our blood. Now the adrenal gland, this adrenal gland are at the supra position. Ad means supra, supra means superior position, upper position. So it, you will find it locates at the upper position of the kidney. A pair of adrenal glands are available there and they are having various functions. Now here pancreas is having both the functions, endocrine as well as exocrine functions. Their tips are containing the Langerhans cells. Now gonads, so this is the female gonads, ovaries. They are able to secrete the various hormones like LH, FSH, and the male gonad, which is called testes. A pair of testes is there, and they are able to release the hormone like testosterone, and they are responsible for production of sperms as well. Now there is a master gland in our brain which is called pituitary gland, which is near the hypothalamus, and it is able to control all over the body. Now how does the endocrine system work, that we will discuss here. In that, various glands are the adrenal gland, thyroid gland, and the gonads. So sense of various processes in the bodies. Actually in our body the homeostasis is going to be maintained. How it can be maintained? It can be maintained by the three processes: receptors, after that their processing, and effector. So by these three way our homeostasis, internal environment, can be maintained, controlled. So these various glands are secreting their hormones and they will show their effects. And the hormonal response, hormonal release, and that response are depends on the mechanisms. It may be negative feedback mechanism. Whenever anything is going to be decreased in our body, decreased level, the receptors are sending that message, spreading that message, carrying that message from that effector, that typical part, toward the brain, toward the processing unit, and from that they are taking the action and you are getting this effect. Now here, this is the pancreas. As you know, the pancreas is exocrine as well as endocrine system. So it releases the insulin, which is a sense of blood glucose concentration. So whenever there is the sense of blood glucose concentration is high in our body, whenever you are taking any food material and already you are having food in our body, the concentration of carbohydrate, sugar is too much high in our body. So it sensitizes your organ, that is pancreas. And due to that increased volume, increased level of sugar and carbohydrate, it will give messages to the brain, and from the brain it give order to the pancreas to secrete the insulin. And insulin will control the level of our glucose, carbohydrate, and they will normalize the blood glucose. They will normalize the blood glucose by two ways: either utilizing them, and second, by converting them from glucose to glycogen. Now here, most hormones are of two types. One is protein hormones and another is steroid hormones. We already discussed the types of hormones. Again we are discussing here in short. In protein hormones, insulin, growth hormone is there, angiotensin, and parathyroid hormone is there. And in case of steroid, LH means luteinizing hormone, FSH follicle stimulating hormone, and testosterone. So these are the hormones which you will find in steroids, means they are lipid hormones, lipid containing hormone. Now hormones, thyroid hormone, testosterone. So as we know, thyroid hormones are responsible for various metabolic processes. They are responsible for various metabolism of carbohydrate, proteins, of fats. They are also responsible for releasing the various enzymes. They are also controlling our menstruation. The thyroid hormone is having lots of functions. Now testosterone. Testosterones are affecting on our gonads, it is acting on male. In female it is available at very less quantity, very rare quantity. And this testosterone is also responsible for secondary sexual characters, and they are responsible for development of testes. Now thyroid hormone. Thyroid hormone almost available in all the cells, and they are responsible for the metabolism of all the cells. Now hormone act by binding to the receptor. Typical receptor, they will bind and they will show their actions. Now receptors and hormones. So whenever any decrease level of anything occurs, for example sugar level is there or calcium level is there, so immediately the receptor will gather information and it will that can carry information through the blood, and it will carry towards our brain, towards our pituitary gland, and from that they are releasing, they are taking the actions and they are doing their functions and they are showing their effects. And the release of the hormone depends on various mechanisms. First is ion channel receptor, second is enzyme linked receptor, and third is gene coupled receptor. So by these three way the hormones will work. Now by ion channel receptor, the various ion channels are there, means voltage gated ion channels are there. Ion channels means sodium ion channels, chloride ion channels, calcium ion channels, like this various ion channels are there, means the receptors are open and closed due to the voltage gated ions, means sodium ions or calcium ions or potassium ions. So when that ions will open and close, channels will open and close, and ions will get enter or exit. So that decides the release of our hormone. So they located on the cell membrane and opens or close due to the voltage, and ion channels membranes, they will enter the ions. And enzyme linked receptor, especially here I will put one example of insulin. Insulin is specially working by this enzyme linked receptor, and in this again there is the activation of these enzymes. For example, tyrosine kinase enzyme is there, and due to the activation of that enzyme, the G-protein coupled receptor will activate and they will start to form the protein. The complex formation will be there after the enzyme linked receptor. Tyrosine kinase receptor is there, it is responsible for that, and after that complex formation will be there, and finally the protein synthesis will occur, and that protein synthesis is responsible for production and release of insulin hormone, the respective hormone. And third type is gene coupled receptor, where the activation and transcription of gene in nucleus is there. Actually this is the gene expression receptor, in which the gene expression occurs. They are the straddle receptors, straddle hormones are there. For example, testosterone, progesterone, they will work by that mechanism. Now we will discuss regarding the thyroid hormone. It is one of the largest endocrine gland. It is having weight about 15 to 20 grams, and it is butterfly like shape, and they are able to release two types of hormones. One is T4, it is called thyroxine, and T3, it is called triiodothyronine. Thyroxine also called as tetraiodothyronine. Out of them, this thyroxine is available at 93%, but whereas this triiodothyronine is available at 7%. But as we know, we have discussed their storage, release, function and conversion. Also we have discussed their coupling process. We also discussed their iodine trapping process. So in that, though thyroxine is 93%, but interconversion occurs from thyroxine to the triiodothyronine, means T3, from T4 to T3, their interconversion occurs, due to which the level of thyroxine and T3 going to be maintained. That depends on their requirement. If there is more T4, in that case it will get converted into the T3, and when there is a less T4, in that case it will remain as it is and it can be utilized in our body. So as you know, the need iodine for this synthesis, and how much it require, it requires almost 1 mg per week. So that very trace less amount of that iodine is required for the process of thyroxine production. Without iodine it is just impossible to produce the thyroxine. Thyroid hormone are very difficult to produce. And the thyroid stimulating hormone, which can be released from the pituitary gland, it is responsible for enhance the process of thyroid hormone production, means T4 production. Now protein hormones. So these are the hormones which are responsible for various functions in our body. They containing the various elements. In that, they are responsible for production of this mitochondria in all over the body, and mitochondria is responsible for ATP generation. These protein nanos are also responsible for fat and carbohydrate metabolism and activity of ion channels, and they are available in all over the body. In each and every cell, the thyroid hormone is having their effect. Means they are controlling the metabolism. They are controlling the metabolism of all the body cells. All over the body, they are spread. They have spread. They are having their actions. That's why they are responsible for body development. They are responsible for structural development, means skeletal development, muscular development. They are also responsible for mental growth. They are also having effect on our brain, on nervous system. All over the nervous system, they are having their effects. So that's why we have to discuss this. They are also having effect of cardiac output and heart rate. They are increasing cardiac output and also increasing the heart rate, and also CNS and GIT activity. Now, parathyroid hormone. This parathyroid hormone is also called as parathyroid hormone. They are located just behind the thyroid. They are in 4 in numbers, tiny structures is there, and they are able to produce the parathyroid hormone. They are regulating the levels of calcium and phosphate metabolism, and they are maintaining a constant concentration into the blood. This parathyroid hormone or parathyroid hormone is responsible for maintain the calcium and phosphate levels. Now, how they are maintaining, that we will discuss here. So by figure, by this video, you will able to well understood this concept, how this parathyroid hormone is maintaining. So try to understand here. They are maintaining the level of calcium into the blood, means they are increasing the calcium, blood calcium level. Whenever there is the receptor, whenever tells that our blood calcium level is decreased, in blood calcium level is very low, decreased. So that can be sensitized by this body, and it will give the response, it will give to the that sensory response toward the brain, and from the brain it will release the hormone accordingly, and it will give order to the parathyroid hormone to release that parathyroid gland to release the parathyroid hormone, due to which it will start to show its action. Now, where it will start to show its action? It will show its action by three ways. What is our main goal? We have to increase the blood calcium level, means in blood calcium level is going to be rise. So how it will rise? It will rise by three ways. First, it will work on our bones. So bones are the major reservoir of calcium. It means bone are containing almost 60-70% of calcium. So what this hormone is doing? They are releasing the calcium from the bones by the cells. They are releasing from the bones, and due to which the bone will containing more calcium. By the second way, they are regulating the excretion, means whatever the calcium which is going to be into our urine, so they won't allow to go into your urine, means they are blocking their release, they are blocking their wastage into the urine. So they will increase the reabsorption of calcium into the kidney. They are increasing reabsorption, due to which the calcium will come back into the blood. And the third important way, that is regulate the absorption through the small intestine. They will give pressure on the small intestine, they will give order to the small intestine to increase the reabsorption of calcium, and due to which again in blood calcium level is going to be rise. So by these three way, first by resorption, second by decrease the secretion and increase the absorption from tubules, renal tubules from the kidneys, and by increasing the absorption from the small intestine. So by these three ways they are, and also it will activate the one element, it is called vitamin D3. Its activated form is calcitriol. It will release the calcitriol, and due to which calcitriol also is responsible for increase the absorption of calcium from the small intestine. So in this fashion, this parathyroid hormone is doing its function. Yes, it is also responsible for synthesis of vitamin D. It is also called as calcitriol. Now here, the adrenal glands are there. They are located at the superior position of the kidneys. And ad means superior, upper position. The external part is called as cortex and the internal part is called as medulla. Both the parts are having their major functions. Out of them, the cortex part, this cortex part is having great role into the endocrine system. It is responsible for release various hormones. Now they are having three parts. The adrenal cortex is having three parts. One is zona glomerulosa, it is the upper part. Second middle part is zona fasciculata, and the third part is zona reticularis. And this is the three part. After that, medulla will start. These layers of adrenal cortex are responsible for release of various hormones. That also we will see one by one. Now there are three major hormones which can regulate their functions. Now first, zona glomerulosa, this GFR, zona glomerulosa, this is the first layer of our endocrine system, which is responsible for release of mineralocorticoid. It is called as aldosterone. This aldosterone can be released from the kidney, from DCT, from the principal cells. It will release, and it is responsible for reabsorption of sodium ions into the blood. Means they are increasing the sodium ion absorption, and sodium come into the blood along with the water molecule. That's why what it will do, it will increase the blood volume, because in blood more and more absorption will occur, and due to which blood pressure can be increased. So it is a functions of mineralocorticoid, and it maintain the constant level of electrolytes, sodium, potassium and other electrolytes, fluids can be maintained. Now next is zona fasciculata. It is a middle layer, and it is responsible for release of cortisol. It is a glucocorticoid, and it is essential for various life functions. It is also released into the stress. It has multiple organ system, multiple metabolism. It is responsible for essential functions for proper stress management. Stress management only occurs due to these glucocorticoids. It is also essential for proper metabolism of glucose, fats, proteins, and it is also important for the normal blood pressure and immune system. Immune system also can be maintained. That's why whenever you are in stress, your immune system can be affected. You can become ill if you are not mentally fit. That's why mental system, our psychological system, always having effects on our body, on our health. And next part is called zona reticularis, which is a innermost layer, and it is able to secrete the androgen. It is called dihydroepiandrosterone, and it is important for the development of the secondary sexual characters in case of males. Now after this, adrenal medulla, which is the innermost part of the medulla, it can be considered as a part of the sympathetic nervous system, and they are able to release the catecholamines, norepinephrine and epinephrine. They are responsible for fight and flight response. They are accompanied with the autonomic nervous system, and they are responsible for fight and flight response. Due to which this epinephrine and norepinephrine will release. And after that, so thank you very much for watching my this video. We will see in next lecture. Bye.